I've sung some worthy praises in the past of great Australians, people who worked hard to win and pioneer our land. They didn't work for praises, they didn't work for medals, they thrived where there was danger, born to lead and take command. I would like to pay a tribute in this ballad of these brothers. I doubt there'd be another with so much expertise. There wasn't one amongst them who would shirk from any challenge. No, I've never known a family as remarkable as these. A family of 10 brothers and one sister born at Drayton, a little country village on the Queensland Darling Downs. Inheriting the German pride and strong determination, their will to win against all odds surely knew no bounds. They started out with little more than faith and dreams and courage. They grew to prove to all the world those things are all you need. Bert and Stan and Cecil, along with all the brothers, handed Les the reins and said, "We'll follow where you lead." Their women worked beside their men as women of the bush do. They roughed it in the road camps where comforts were so few. They learned to live with hardship, they learned to live with sorrow. For live you must with sorrow, there is nothing else to do. And when they formed the company of these brothers' constructions, the emblem they designed was seen on new roads pushing through. A sign of strength and progress, of romance and adventure, the map of Australia with a proud buck kangaroo. Les guided the team in doing things that couldn't be done, forging ever onward, building bridges, tunnels, dams. From the Jihai in the Snowies to the dry dock in New Guinea, they carved their name in history that will forever stand. They had the guts to gamble on export coal from Queensland, with the foresight of an industry that others couldn't see. And for the men that come behind, they graded that rough highway when they took that black gold mountain to Mohammed or the sea. What they achieved could not have been without a loyal workforce, and loyalty they had through good examples that they set. The brothers never asked a man to do a job they couldn't, and what the brothers couldn't do has not been witnessed yet. From office staff to engineers, from billy boy to pilots, the workers held the brothers in the highest of esteem. From stockmen in the Kimberleys to bar staff at the Barclay, it was loyalty that helped the brothers realize their dream. I am glad I had the privilege of working for the brothers, but never knew how much they'd done until I read the book. Inventors of machinery, pioneers of trade and export, from bauxite in the top end to coal at Muscle Brook. I have never been a yes man who bows to rank and title. There are many wearing honours who most deserve them least. But I humbly take my hat off with respect and admiration to the brothers Lady Tibb and to you, Sir Leslie Thiess.